up, Shallow Bay? I'm the Donkey Punch, sitting here with Ben Burnley. We're in the Ben Cave, and we're about to talk a little bit of gaming for all you gamers out there. So, what exactly are you playing now on the road?
I'm playing an Army of Two and another game called Bully.
So you were given Army of Two high praises now.
Yeah.
What exactly does this game entail? Because I haven't played it yet.
It's really cool. You just like you and either another guy online or whatever. You play the whole game co-op, or you can let the computer control the other guy. It's pretty cool. You have to use teamwork throughout the whole game to complete get through the levels, the enemies. So. Smart AI, they'll hide behind stuff. It's pretty cool. I'll show you once we start playing.
Now this kind of got like a Gears of War feel to it.
Yeah, it's kind of a cross between like Gears of War and I don't know, something else. I mean, the thing that's cooler about this thing, Gears of War, is that headshots kill enemies. So there's a lot of the same mechanics. You can't really wall hug, but you can like pop above it like that.
Right.
Like I said, like if you try to do stuff on your own, you'll die really quick. So right now I'm going to order this guy. There's a thing called aggro, which is why he's glowing red. And the needle at the top is going in his direction.
Yeah.
And that means all the enemies' focus is on him, or most of them. It's going, it's getting more and more. So my guy's kind of translucent. That means they're not paying attention to me, so I can just try to sneak around and flank them from the side while they're all focused on me. The other guy. And then this is cool, you can like fake your death. So that's what I'm doing. I'm faking being dead while I regenerate health. So now we're on Bully. This is a pretty cool game. It's basically like Grand Theft Auto, only you're like this kid that gets sent off to this private school. So now it's 1 o'clock, so the bell just rang. I don't know if you can hear it or not.
Yeah.
But so I gotta go to class before 3, so I'm just gonna go now. So I'm right here. This can get a little boring. But
you have to sit in class?
Yeah, well, you do like mini games. So now I'm in English class. Every class is just basically a mini game, kind of like in Grand Theft Auto when you would go down to the beach and you had to dance and it brings up, like the mini game, like the hot coffee mod, and fucking you have to like get the timing right. And this is like a word jumble. In English class, they give you random letters and you have to get as many words out of it as you can to pass the class. If you pass the class, you can like increase your skills. Like in the game, like you can talk to girls, and if you pass classes in English, you get like better communication skills with the NPCs, which are non-playable characters. So like if I pass this class, I'll be able to like, I don't know what it'll unlock, but it'll basically unlock stuff. So if you're, like rag. Crawling across my skin, feeling your cold dead eyes, stealing the life of mine. I believe in you, I can show you that I can. Yeah. I cheat because it's not that fun to me. I just want to pass the class. I don't find word jumbles to be too fun. So I go online and I look up solutions for a jumble, and you just put in the word and it'll give you all the words.
Oh, I thought you could actually like cheat on your classmates' papers.
No. That'd be cool if you could. Maybe Bully 2 will do that. I failed.
So now the game's called Bully. Can you like run around and beat up people?
Yeah, that was just a class. Now like the actual game's pretty cool. Stars are your objectives, side missions and stuff. This is actually funny. This is my least favorite things to do. There was this one mission that was pretty cool where you had to trash the principal, not the principal, you had to like trash one of the teachers' houses and stuff.
Yeah.
And the cops come and you like hide in these bases and shit.
So real quick, give us your top five games of all time.
Of all time, my top five games. Well, Oblivion's number one. That's the best game I've ever played. And then Call of Duty is probably number two for multiplayer, online multiplayer. I love it way better than Halo, just because. Sorry, guys, but just because it's more realistic and I'm more into that. Rainbow would have to be three for online play. Five. I'd have to look through. I don't get a 9. 3.
We stick with 3. Top 3 is good. Top 3 is good.
I play so many games.
Right.
And then there's like genres, sub-genres.
Right. Alright, well, there you have it. There's a little glimpse into Ben's gaming on tour. Obviously, no online play. He did try it for Call of Duty, and it completely didn't work out. Thanks for tuning in, and hopefully we'll have some more backstage footage coming for you soon.
Alright, I'm gonna do it. You gotta edit it in there.
Okay.
All right. Somehow. This one, you gotta put the whole thing in. This one goes out to Gorb and Bonafide, and I know I'm gonna leave a few out. But Pump Pump and all my Xbox Live boys. What time is it? Game time. What time is it? Game time. Dogs in the house. They'll like that. They'll hate that, actually. I want you to get that real quick.